Today I will show you how to make country balls in Photoshop. We will only use the pencil tool and at the end I will show you how to make a nice background for our little guy. Okay, so first of all, let's create a canvas. I will create a 400 by 400 canvas. We all have to select the pencil tool because Polandball is only made with the pencil tool. So we'll just go ahead and click on the brush. If we right click it, we'll see the pencil tool right here. Now with the pencil tool selected, we will click on this plus icon and we will add a new layer. We'll name it border. Okay, so the brush is just too big, so we will hold the Alt key, right click and move our mouse to the left, which will make the diameter smaller. Now we'll have something that we actually need and we will use. Now a pro tip, if you have like these jagged lines and it looks kind of weird, you can just go into this menu and make spacing to 1% and it will make all the lines a bit smoother. You can also use smoothing up here. I usually use 20%, so that will also help you. Now let's make our ball. I usually make it wider on the bottom to simulate that it's heavy. I think that something like this is great. I might just erase this part, so I will select the eraser tool, but that is the mode and I have to switch the mode from brush to pencil so it doesn't make faded edges. So let's zoom in a bit. I will delete it like so. But if you don't like it, a thing you can do is turn this into a smart object. So right click it, convert to a smart object. This will, even if you scale it down and then scale it up, it will keep the detail. It will keep the detail, which is what we want. So what did I do now? So you will press Ctrl plus T and this will open up the transform window. You can make things bigger. If you hold Shift, you can even make it like wider. If you don't hold Shift, it will keep the aspect ratio. Now we don't need to scale it, we will just press Ctrl T and we will press this little button up here. With this we can actually move our selection to make it a bit rounder. So we can try to make it round, but here is an edge. I can't really make it not edgy. And so what I will do is I will press Ctrl once again. This will give me like this weird crosshair, which I can put like somewhere around here. And now it will only affect this area between this and this. So it's not the actual full width, like from here to here, but only this small area, so I can make it rounder. Okay, so that's done. Now we will move to the flag. Now this is important. Keep in mind this is a ball, and so the flag should look round also. So we'll create a new layer. So for this tutorial, I selected I would do the French country ball. So now we'll have to get the colors of the French flag. You can use some websites on the internet for this. I will link them down in the description. Now if you have copied the hex, which are 6-digit numbers or letters, we will just paste it into this hashtag thingy. So let's just Ctrl V and it's not working. So I have found that the French blue is 0050A4. So we'll just put it in this hashtag thingy, click OK, and now we have the French blue color. Now you can either draw the flag normally, which will just mean that you make something like this. And this is like very crude. I'm not even trying to fit it into the ball and just fill it in with the blue. Now we'll do the same for the red, so I will just get the red color, paint it like this, now we'll fill it in, and then in the middle, white, like so. Now if you don't see where you are painting, you can just make a new layer, fill it with light green, and fill it in the background, now you will see exactly where you are painting. Now that it's filled in, we can select the three layers by clicking the first layer at the bottom, then holding Shift and clicking the top one, which will select all the three layers at once. Right click it and select Merge Layers. This will make the flag into one large thing. Now we can lower the opacity a bit so we actually see what's behind it. And we can use the Ctrl T again, move it on the ball, stretch it a bit, make it a bit bigger, center it, and we can move to this menu like we did before. Two things we can do. We can do it the normal way, but just by moving it and trying to position it like we did before, or we can click the warp tool and select the inflate or fisheye. And what this does is this weird filter, which we can use, we can make it like large. It's not fitting our ball, but we can click out of it and scale it down and try to match it with our ball, and maybe we will get some nice result if we put it like this. For now we'll just accept it, make the opacity 100% and put it in the background. We can see that if we want a ball that is looking right in front of us onto the screen, that this will work. And if you want something like this, then this is great. I will want the ball to look at a certain direction. I will press Ctrl Z to return it back, and we'll do Ctrl T once again. I will move it, position it onto the ball so I know what I'm working with. Transfer it once again, do something like this, I suppose. So it will be looking to the right. I think this is fine. Turn the opacity to 100%. Now we can't see the ball, so we'll move the flag behind it. Because we are using the pen tool, which does not do jagged edges, we can just nicely select it with the wand tool. So we'll click the border. Now what do we want to do next is click on the flag layer, which I will rename to flag. Always rename your layers because it's very important. And we will click this button with the rectangular with a hole in it, which is masking. It will basically hide the not necessary things you need and make them disappear. But if you want to get them back, you can just select the pencil tool, click not on the layer, but on the mask, the black and white thing, and have white selected, and you can just paint right over it and it will appear again. And if you want to hide it again, you will click the black color and just paint it back like so. But we don't want to do that now, so this will be enough. Now before we get to the background, you can see that something missing. Well, our ball can't see. So we'll need to make some eyes. So let's make a new layer, name it eyes, and pick the same color as you picked for the border. So for me, it will be this right here. Let's zoom in, make it a bit smaller, preferably the size of the border, not bigger. If you make like the eyes bigger, it will just look weird. So try to make it the same size as the border, or maybe a bit, even a bit smaller. You can have the eyes here. This will look weird. You can't really do that. You'll have to go along with the flag we have here. If the flag is pointing in this direction, we will have to make the eyes in this direction, right? I want some happy French ball. Zoom in a bit and let's make a smiley face. You can either make a new layer and do a separate eye and try to look at it and have it like this. Or what I do is I have just one eye and then I hover my mouse onto the layer, press Alt key, hold it and move it up, which will make a copy of it. Or you can just press Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. It also works. You can just move it like so, which they will be the same, but I feel it looks more unison and the symmetry is something I like. So now there are a lot of layers in our project and it can get a little bit messy. So let's select the two eyes by holding once again, selecting one of them and holding Shift key, selecting the other. Click Ctrl-G. This will make a group. Now the group is hidden. We can open it by selecting this little arrow on the left. The group can also have a name. So let's name it eyes. Now we can't have eyes like that because we see the red and we don't want that. We want to have our eyes white. So let's make a new layer, put it on the back and select our white tool. If you zoom in and you see this grid like I did, well, I can't really see it now. Yes, if you see this grid, how you can get rid of it is press Ctrl H and it will disappear. Now we will just paint it white just like we want to. And now once again, if you don't see, if you missed any spots, which now it seems like you didn't, right? It looks fine. But if you hide the flag, oh, we see that we missed something. So let's just fix that a bit and turn our flag on again. Now these are some happy eyes. And if you got this far, you might as well subscribe and like the video so you will see more of this content. Okay, so now for the background. We'll delete this green layer, but I might actually use the color because I actually pretty like it. So let's select it. You can select colors by holding the Alt key while having the pencil tool selected, and it will show you this eyedropper tool. So you can actually click it anywhere you want and it will select the color. So let's get rid of this layer and make a new one. I have decided to make a grassland, so our French ball will be sitting on grass. Let's draw something like this. Fill it with the green so it looks pretty fine, I suppose. But as you might see here, it's still a bit off. Like, there is not much going on and it's kind of boring. So let's unlock this background by clicking this little lock so we can actually paint on it. And let's select some blue color. Usually the sky, I like to make it white, or not really white, but like not very saturated. Usually I like to make my sky not very saturated. So let's go for something like this, maybe even something like this. Okay, let's see how it will look. So let's click the fill bucket again and fill it in. Now this looks way better. But what you can also do, if you think this is still a bit boring, we can make a new layer, get our green again, and we can make multiple hills behind it. One thing to keep in mind, there is fog in between anything. So if you look from a tower into distance, you will see white eventually. The horizon will be white because there is just fog and the atmosphere is hiding it. So keep in mind that everything that is more far away from the camera will be more white. So we'll select the green, but we will make it a bit whiter than before. Now we'll move to the layer behind the grass. And we'll just paint a new layer. So maybe like a hill up here. Yeah, I think this looks fine. We can just fill it in once again. And this looks way better. We can do it once again for the very last time. So let's make it even more whiter. And yeah, I think let's make it something like this. If you think it's too high, what you can do is just select one of the layers. Click Control. which will select the move tool and move it a bit down. We can do that same thing for the last thing. And now we have some nice hills. Please tell me in the comments how your hills turned out. What we can do now, once again, we can just select these three items. Select the first one, shift, select the third one. Let's click Control G, which will make the group once again. And let's name it background. We can now click the whole group and once again click Control and move it even a bit down, just so it would look maybe a bit better. So yeah, just to look a bit better maybe. And now, a bit of a bonus, what we can try to do to make this less boring and even more look like nature, we can select the background, make it the group once again, name it sky. We can select it, make a new layer, select white, then we can take the pencil tool and do something like this. It doesn't look that good, but what we can do is turn the opacity to like 15%. Now this will give us some sort of a gradient, but it still doesn't look the best. So what we can do is Control Alt once again and copy it. This is 15%, this is 15%. So this started to look more white. Now this is 30%, right? But on this new layer, we will paint some more to the top of it. So now it has two different white colors instead of one. But we will do this once again, and it's even more white now. We'll just move it like so once again, and maybe for the last time. What we have here is just some nice fade, and I guess we could also maybe turn it a bit down so it's not 15% but only 10. And if you're not happy with how it looks, we can maybe turn it a bit down so we still see the original sky. And I think this is starting to look pretty good, but it's in nature and in open space we have light, so let's do some shadows. This will be a special thing. So what I like to do is take my entire ball, press Ctrl G, name it ball. Yes. What else we can do now is select some dark color once again, make a new layer, and we can make a clipping layer out of this. You do that by moving it up before the thing you want to clip at. You press Alt and hover your mouse between the ball layer and layer 10. This will make a little arrow with a rectangle, and we will just click it and it will clip it. You can see the little arrow. Now what this does is that when we have this dark color, we can just paint it on the ball, which is this element, but we can't paint it outside. We can't do that. It's not possible. If we unclip it by once again holding Alt and clicking between it, you can see that we are painting outside of it. But if we clip it once again, it's clipped to the ball and it can't really go anywhere. Now if we undo it, we can just start painting. So let's say the sun is coming from this direction. So what we will want to do is to make a shadow out here, like so. Now we will fill it in, we'll close it first. You have to keep in mind that it's still open. So we'll try to paint it, like so, and fill it in with the bucket tool. And as you can see, there are some jagged lines along here. You can see that the flag is not 100% covering the entire ball, and there is a space between it. So easy fix, you just open the ball group once again, click the flag, press Ctrl T, and instead of like moving it like this and then just moving it back into place, what we can do is just press Ctrl T, start moving it, but also hold the Alt key, which will make it big on all the sides. And if we hold the Shift key, it will keep the aspect ratio. We'll just move it like so. It's now nicely filled in. So, but let's now move back to our shadow. Let's rename it to Shadow. Showed, not so much. Shadow. And let's turn the opacity to like 15%. Maybe this is not enough for you, so we can like turn it to 20. This is starting to get a lot better. But now it looks also kind of weird because our ball is hovering in the air. So to fix this, we can just make a new layer under the ball. Keep in mind that the light is coming from this direction, so we will have to make some shadow that is here but not here, because it wouldn't make much sense. Let's make something like this, fill it in once again, hold Control and move it, and we can make it less opaque. Now if we don't want this hard shadow, we can lower the opacity even a bit further, maybe to like 30%, and once again duplicate it by holding the Alt key on the layer and moving it a bit up, and then using transform tool to make it a bit smaller and moving it under this. What we have here is some nice country ball. Now the last bonus tip, we can make it a nice hat. Now to do that, we'll just open the ball group, and we'll create a new layer and select a color that will look like a beret, maybe even let's get a really dark one, so it's even darker than the border. And now let's think about how big we want the hat to be, because we can make like a small hat, but we can also make a large hat. It really depends on us and however we want to take it. So I might go for like a small beret, maybe make it a bit brighter. I think something like this should do probably. Make the little thing on top, fill it in with black, This does not seem right, so let's take the eraser tool and erase some of the things that looks odd. It looks maybe still a bit dark, so what we can do is we can select this little round icon here and do hue and saturation. We can customize the lightness of this, but as you can see, it customizes the whole thing. So we once again want to clip it, so Alt between it, clip it by clicking, and now it's clipped only to the beret. So we want to make it a bit brighter, I suppose, and move it up a bit so it's on his head. Now we want to do some shadows, so let's make a new layer. Move it up above this adjustment layer. Let's make a black shadow. So I suppose, oh, I have an eraser, that's not gonna work. I suppose we could make it darker here, around here, maybe make like a small line. And let's cut it on the right side. So let's do something like this. And I think this looks a bit better. Now, as you can see, this shadow is too dark compared to this head. So we can just go to this adjustment layer and maybe make it a bit darker once again. So something like this. And now, if we want to do some more adjustments to it, we can copy it by pressing Alt key once again, so copy it like this. And we can hide the original and select the copy, click it, and select Merge Group. This will make another hat, but it's not separated in these layers, but it's one object. So we'll rename it to hat once again, and what this allows us to do is when we press Ctrl T, we can use this button again. So we can add another point by clicking the Ctrl key. I think this looks pretty fine. I'm not really all that used to making hats, but I think this hat turned out pretty well. So yeah, this hat was more of a bonus. At the end, maybe you have made a better hat than me, maybe you have made something else, maybe you can add a baguette. Tell me down in the comments what you have made, how it looks. If you enjoyed this video, you can like, comment, and subscribe, most of all, so you will see more of the tutorials, which will be really, really, really amazing of you. So yeah, thank you for watching today's video. Hope you enjoyed it, hope it was straightforward, and I will see you in the next one.